Recently, Charger Lab got a 260 watts DC to USB power extender from SlimQ. It has two USB-C ports, two USB-A ports, and one DC socket. It has a maximum output power of 260 watts. Next, let's do some tests to see its charging performance. The power extender comes with a silicone protective cover, which improves its drop resistance and isolates the heat it generates to prevent burns. Remove the protective cover. Its shell is made of blue-black aluminum alloy and uses an anodizing process. Each USB-C port has a maximum output of 100 watts. The other side has a DC output port in the middle. Input voltage range is 5 to 24 volts, and USB-A output ports on both sides, with a maximum output of 30 watts. All four ports can output independently, and the maximum total output can reach 260 watts, which is 100 watts plus 100 watts plus 30 watts plus 30 watts. Its size is about 48.4 by 71.9 by 19.9 millimeters, and the weight is about 65 grams. Next, we use the SlimQ3 30 watts charger to power the extender for the protocol test. Charger Lab Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C 1C2 port can support QC3+, FCP, AFC, PD3.0, PPS, QC5, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amp charging protocols. And it has 5 fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 12 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, 20 volts 5 amps, and 2 sets of PPS, which are 3.3 to 11 volts 3 amps and 3.3 to 21 volts 3 amps. Charger Lab Power ZKM003C shows the USB-A 1A2 port can support QC3.0, FCP, SCP, AFC, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amp charging protocols. Next, let's do the compatibility test. The USB-C port is compatible with the 100 watt PD protocol. There is no problem charging laptops and tablets. Most phones can maintain a power of 11 to 27 watts. Some phones that support PD or PPS protocols can reach a power of 30 to 54 watts. Move to the USB-A. There is no compatibility issue. Most phones can reach a voltage of 9 volts. The power of Huawei Pura 70 Pro Plus can reach 20.81 watts. Since the four ports are independent outputs, both USB-C ports can provide 100 watt PD output. Even with two more USB-A ports, the 100 watt output of the two USB-C ports is not affected. Next, we'll use the USB-C port of the SlimQ 260 watts DC to USB power extender to fully charge the MacBook Pro 16 M1 Max. The power extender and the MacBook will be put into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. Here is the charging curve made by the PC software of KM003C. The voltage is always around 20 volts. The charging curve can be divided into four parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 93 watts for the first 39 minutes. Then, the power gradually drops to 67 watts and 43 watts in turn. The final part begins at 1 hour and 6 minutes. The power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 3 minutes to be fully charged. We also turn it into another curve. The power extender can charge the MacBook Pro 16 M1 Max to 50% in 32 minutes. And it can reach 80% in 56 minutes. 100% in 2 hours and 3 minutes. Then, we are going to the temperature test. We put the power extender into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank and recorded the highest temperature on the front and back under the load of 20 volts 5 amps after 1 hour. After 1 hour, the maximum temperature on the front is about 51.2 degrees Celsius. The maximum temperature on the back is about 51.4 degrees Celsius. The temperature on both sides is almost the same. The silicone protective cover it comes with can reduce the perceived temperature when you touch it. The SlimQ 260 watts DC to USB power extender solves the problem of the DC adapter not being able to charge commonly used devices. It supports 5 to 24 volts DC input. It has a maximum output power of 100 watts plus 100 watts plus 30 watts plus 30 watts, which is 260 watts. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.